Hello and welcome back. If you're new here, hi, my name is Molly. Welcome to my channel. I am so excited for today's video. I've been meaning to do this for so long and I'm finally getting around to doing my newborn must-haves. So I'm gonna be sharing with you everything that I feel like is essential slash stuff that I feel like is really helpful when you do have a newborn. I have a 3-month-old daughter named Penelope and also a almost 2-year-old son named Rowan. So this is my second child. So I feel like I have a good gripping on like what you need versus things that, you know, are nice and to have. So I will also share with you like what I think is like stuff you absolutely need and then stuff I think is like extra and nice to have. So let's go ahead and get started with today's video. So I'm gonna kind of do this, I think, in like categories so it's easier to follow. I always feel like that's a little bit helpful. So I'm first gonna start with sleep because I feel like sleep is what we all want when we have our newborns. We are craving sleep. We are trying to figure out their sleep schedules. We're just wanting to know what can possibly help us with sleep. So few of our absolute favorite things. First off is the Hatch Baby Rest. I have just the original one. This is like the first version. I know they have the new one that has like the clock on it. You can get that one if you'd like. It's a little more expensive. So I actually have two of these. I have one for my son Rowan and then I also have one for my daughter. And I opted just to get the original one again just because I don't feel like we really need the time on there since it's just going to go in the kids' room. But it is so helpful, you guys. So nice to have this. I feel like it really does help with getting them in a routine of hearing like a sound machine and then knowing they're gonna go to bed. So also it does really well at canceling out noises. We have two dogs, so for us it gets a little loud, and when we have this on at night, Rowan knows as soon as he turns this on it's time for bed, so he actually turns this on himself. So it's super helpful for toddlers too, but especially for newborns, because I feel like it just does calm them, soothe them, and it does give them into that routine of knowing like, okay, this is turning on, now it's time for bedtime. So we have used it religiously with Rowan, and then we have also used it with Penelope, and I hands down love this thing. You can use it with your phone as well, so you can pair it with your phone, control it that way. It has, if you don't want like white noise, it has other like sounds on it. There's lullabies, you can do like rainfall, things like that. It doesn't have to be the white noise sounds, but it also has light on it too, so this is also helpful for like those middle of the night nursing sessions. You can just tap it and turn on a light, so I do like that for that as well. Okay, and then my next essential is going to be a swaddle. Now, I know everyone kind of feels a certain way about swaddles, and I know people say, like, don't get, you know, too many, and not all babies like to be swaddled, so forth and so on. But both of my kids have loved these swaddles. So these are the Swaddle Me brand, and I get them on Amazon. They actually come in like a 3-pack. You can order them individually too if you'd like. I have personally found these to be easiest just because they are a Velcro swaddle. So pretty much all you have to do is put your babe in there, you Velcro here, and then Velcro here, and they like stay in it like a little burrito. And I don't have any issues with them like wiggling out of this one. I've tried some other ones where they have like their arms have been able to cut loose and like they get out of it. I feel like these are super tight and they're also nice and soft. And I think they're just really easy to use and really user friendly. They come in different sizes too. This is the smallest size, but then they go up to medium. So we did use the medium ones for Rowan because he was a little bit of a bigger baby. We started out with the smalls and then we transferred. So with Penelope, she's still in the small ones. They also make some that have a zipper down at the bottom to do your diaper changes. So if that's something you want to get as well, we have one of those ones. They're a little bit more pricey than these ones. But honestly, you guys, I know this sounds like kind of, you know, I don't know, controversial maybe, because I feel like a lot of people change their babies in the night. I started with Penelope not changing her in the nighttime. So I actually started to in the beginning, and I feel like I was like almost waking her up more by changing her. And so I just stopped doing it altogether. She was probably like 2 weeks old when I stopped changing her. And I feel like it made such a difference with her sleep. She was just able to like sleep longer, and now she's used to it. So like she doesn't even whine, you know, for a diaper change or anything. Obviously if she was like poopy or something, I would change her, but it's just made it so much easier with her night's sleep. So anyways, these are great. I'm gonna put links to, I forgot to mention, to everything down in the description box here. So if you want to check anything out, I will put my links. I am also going to recommend the Owlette sleep sack. So I know that this isn't like something that's gonna be for everyone. It is a pricey product. And I know everyone kind of has their thoughts on that because it is so pricey and something like that. It's not something that's essential, but for me, it does give me peace of mind. I do have anxiety, and I feel like it just helps me to know that she has that on, to know that something's like checking her oxygen levels and such. So for me, it's more of like a peace of mind thing. And it does help me. We used it with my son Rowan, and then we're using it now. We actually ended up, Rowan's ended up the sensor breaking, which is a bummer because it is such an expensive product. And I purchased it thinking I would have it for two kids, but because customer service was really nice over there. So I ended up calling them, telling them my issue, and they ended up helping us get a new one. So we do have the Smart Sock 3 now, I believe is what it's called. And I definitely recommend that one because it does have a longer battery life. And also the range works a little bit better. So it's not like, so like if she's in the living room, it's not saying that, you know, it's too far from the base because we keep the base in the bedroom. That was an issue we had with the previous Sock, but I do recommend that just for the ease of mind. We got ours on Black Friday, so it's something that you can always try to get on sale if you can, because it is a little bit more of an expensive item. And then our Lollipop baby camera, that is something that we love for nighttime use as well. We have one for my son Rowan as well, and I think it's a great monitor. We love it. I love that you can monitor both kids at the same time. I'll put like a little picture, but you can basically see both of them at the same time. You can hear them both. The picture quality on it is really good. It is a Wi-Fi monitor, but I don't really see any issues with it. Every once in a while it will kind of cut out a little bit, but it's normally not really an issue, and we have enjoyed it. And I like how just easy it is. It has a stem on it, so you can kind of wrap it around your crib. Rowan's is wrapped around his shelf, and I feel like it's really useful that you don't have to like nail it into the wall or anything like that. So I do think that that is helpful. The next thing with sleep is actually bassinet sheets. So we do have a small bassinet that she sleeps in at night. And this is something that I never seen really anyone talking about, was actual bassinet sheets. And I feel like they are so essential, and that you have like quite a few of them, because they are going to spit up. They are, you know, going to have accidents or whatever. So you're going to need multiple sheets. And so I remember with my son Rowan, I only had, I think, a set of two, and I like wasn't even thinking to get more. And I like flew through those, because laundry, like I feel like you're doing laundry so much in the beginning, and it's just not something you want to be without. If they're spitting up all over it, like what are you supposed to do? So definitely get yourself a few packs of sheets. These are some of our favorites. They're like a jersey knit, and I grabbed these from Amazon. They come in a pack of two or three, and I would just tell you, just get a few packs so that you have some for your bassinets, and then you have extras so you don't have to worry about washing them as much. Speaking of laundry, I recommend getting one of these baskets. This is one that has wheels on it, because you are doing so much laundry in the beginning that I feel like having something with wheels is super helpful, that where you can just like wheel this around the house if you need to. Honestly, her clothes are everywhere. I feel like we throw clothes like in her bedroom, some are in our living room, some are in like her bedroom, like they're everywhere. So I recommend one of these where you can just kind of wheel it around. I found mine at Target. Okay, and then staying with sleep, I do have two favorite sleepers. So I have mentioned this in my newborn must haves with my son, but the Cloud Island sleepers from Target are my absolute favorite. I think that they are so cozy, and I feel like they just last really well. They wash really well. They have the mitten pullovers on the arms, and then they also have the feet on the bottom, and they are so affordable. So it's $12.99 for three of them. They do zip all the way down too, so they actually have a zipper, so you can come at the bottom so you can change them really quickly. You don't have to take them all the way out. Nothing but amazing things to say about these. She has lived in them. I bought a bunch of them this time around, and I have them in like every size. They do only go up to, I believe it's the 9 to 12 is the last like size they go into, but lived in these. Rowan lives in these. She lives in them. And then I really do like the ones from Old Navy as well. These are their ribbed materials. It's a 3 to 6 month size, but these are really nice as well. They also have the mitten cover-ups if you want to do that, but I find these really comfortable, and they're nice and stretchy, so they are going to last a little bit longer. These ones aren't as stretchy, because I feel like they will kind of grow out of these quicker, but these ones stretch pretty well, so I feel like they can wear them a little bit longer. They have really cute colors. Again, these are from Old Navy, and I like that they can zip from the bottom as well. That is something I would look for when you're looking for your sleepers, just because you are changing them so much throughout the day and stuff. So much easier when they have that like half zip up, and that way you can just like undress them, change your diaper, and then zip them back down. You don't have to take them fully out of the clothes. And then we're going to kind of transition into like some other clothing items. So this is from this is the Gerber. These are just the plain onesies. You can really get any brand, but just make sure you have some just plain ones that they can just wear underneath their clothes, because I know for her, I'm always layering her, so she's wearing like a little onesie underneath this, the little bodysuits. And I recommend just getting like plain white ones. I mean, you can get, you know, colored ones if you want. She has some other print ones and stuff, but the plain white ones I feel like are nicer, because you can sometimes see the collar underneath these, and I feel that I prefer just like the plain white there. But just grab a couple packs of those to have with your sleepers, because I feel like they are helpful. And then swaddle blankets, little muslin swaddle blankets. These are really nice. I use these a lot with Penelope, just honestly, like all the time. We use these for like spit up rags and stuff too, just because they are like that thicker material. So she'll have these on her leg, like if she's in her swing or something. We have these. She was a summer baby, so outside a lot, I would have one of these. It's just like thin, so you can just kind of throw it on them. Like I said, we use it for like spit up and different things. So they're just super helpful to have a few different packs of those and just get a couple of those. This one here is just one that I got from TJ Maxx. I feel like you don't have to go super expensive with them. I do have one from, I believe it's the Aiden and I brand that everyone talks about. And honestly, like I don't notice a difference between that one and this one from TJ Maxx. So I would say just, you know, if you can find them at TJ Maxx, grab those ones because they're pretty affordable. And then I do have a favorite bird cloth. These ones are from Green Spouts. You can find them on Amazon. They are a thicker, like, muslin style. And I love how big they are because these ones are, like, really big. So you can put them, like, right over your shoulder if you want to do that. I just feel like they're really absorbent. And I can kind of use them a lot longer than the other ones that I have because they're a little bit thinner. So this one I can just, like, kind of use half one side one day and then have the other side the other day or something like that because I feel like I'm not having to wash them as much because they are so thick and large. So I definitely recommend these, and I know they come in packs of quite a few. And then we're gonna move into some just like essential things that are helpful. So first off is a diaper caddy. I recommend getting one of these. We actually have two of them in our house, so they're very helpful for those changes and having just like a separate area in your house where you can change them. So I definitely recommend having one of these like in your living room, having one in your bedroom, one in your like nursery, wherever you need to be changing them, kind of have them all over. They're pretty affordable. I think I paid like $10 for this one on Amazon, but you just put your diapers in there, your creams, anything you need just in like these little pockets, and they're easy to carry around. And also that way you have like a diaper station everywhere you are. I know for me personally, I like hardly ever use her changing pad for changing diapers. I don't think she's even ever changed her diaper on there. So for me, it's just more like wherever it's convenient, the couch, the floor, you know, the bed, wherever. So having one of these is super helpful with that. Speaking of her changing table though, I do still want to recommend it. So she has the Hatch Baby Grow, and that is actually a scale changing pad, and I do recommend that one. We got it with our son Rowan and we still have it. We've been using it with Penelope. It's really helpful in these early months to use something like that because I feel like especially if you are breastfeeding, I am breastfeeding, so for me it's helpful to see what she's weighing and to see that she's like gaining weight and such, so you kind of know. There is an app too that goes along with it if you want to use the app, but you can pretty much like weigh them after each feed if you want to. I haven't really done that much this time around, but with Rowan early in his life he was on the lower side, so he was actually having to go back to the pediatrician if he didn't like gain his weight. So I was able to use the Hatch Grow and see that he was gaining his weight, so we didn't have to end up going back. But it is just helpful to kind of ease your mind a little bit in the beginning when you don't know how much they are getting, especially if they are breastfeeding. It's a little bit pricey. I think it's a little over $100, but I definitely recommend it. I do think it's worth it just for the ease of mind. I definitely recommend a pacifier if you can, getting your child to like a pacifier, because I do feel like that is essential in the first few months. It's not like something you need to have, but I do feel like it's super helpful, especially with sleep and everything like that. So the Bibs pacifier would be one I would recommend. She has really loved these, and so far no issues. She like absolutely loves it. She has it in her mouth like all the time, so I've really been liking them. And they're also like kind of cute. I mean, pacifiers aren't really cute, but I do feel like these are some of like the less ugly ones, if you will. Rowan took the Avent Soothy ones and I like hated those, so I was trying to get her not to take those ones, so these were what ended up working out for us. I did try the Avent with her, but she didn't like them. She ended up liking the Bibs. Okay, a couple of random things that I have is actually the Oogie Bear. This is a booger picker, essentially. You can use this for your baby's nose or your baby's ears to just get out the boogers. It really is just super helpful. I don't know what else to say about it. I'm like, is this essential? But it really is something that I feel like everybody needs. It really does help just get out those big ones you can't get out with anything else. It's easier than a nose sucker, and normally this doesn't bother them. Like, I still use it on Rowan, so it's just like this little hook thing, and I use it in their ears. It's really great. And then also I really like the nail clipper. We have an electronic nail trimmer, and this works really well at trimming the baby's nails when you don't want to use like the clippers. It just has all these little attachments to it, and you can actually just use it. It like spins and it just trims their nails really easily, and it's not something that is, you know, hard, and it's not something you're gonna like cut their nails doing. It's really easy. We actually took this to the hospital with Penelope so that we had that to do her first nail trimming with. And then I have the little booty spatula. This is also really helpful for applying your diaper cream. Penelope actually is pretty good. She hasn't had any rashes yet so far, which we've been lucky with, but my son Rowan does get some from time to time. So for for him, we use this all the time, but for her, she hasn't had that issue, but with Rowan, like I said, we did. So using this is just great for your diaper cream. Just go ahead and put this, use your diaper cream, put it right on here, and then just splash it on there. Diaper cream smells really bad, and it's like really like a thick thing that you don't want on your hands. So it's nice to just have this and to spread it, and it works really well. And it has a little silicone thing too, so you can suction it to you wherever you need to, and you won't lose it that way too. And then a few larger items that I do want to recommend is our Love Every Play Gym. I have noticed her loving this, honestly, from like the start. It's been really great for her to have for tummy time. There's a lot of contrasting colors on there, and it does grow with them as well. You've got the things hanging down. There's like a tent that can go over top of it, and it has the little spot for the mirror, which I think is great as well. It's just been a really nice mat. It's very nice quality. It's not like a sore thumb kind of a thing with how it looks. I think she really loves it. Also, I recommend the Fisher Price Kick and Play. She absolutely loves that thing as well. She has used that since she was about a month old. So I definitely recommend getting that one. It has like the little piano at the end. I'll insert some videos and clips of them in both of them. But both of those I do recommend. We had quite a few different other like play gyms and things, and I've like the Love Every by far has been our favorite. But I still do recommend getting the piano player one because that one is really fun for them. And then also a swing. I highly recommend the Fisher Price swing. I feel like that one is just the best for your value. I feel like that one is, I think it's like a little over $100, but I do think it's worth every penny. She loves that thing. It like puts her right to sleep. If we are like next to her, let us sleep in there. But it also has like the little mobile on the top. It doesn't move or anything, but she loves looking up at that. So it also has white noise on there, which I think is nice. And then you can swing it this way, or you can actually flip it and it goes the opposite way. So whatever way your baby likes to be swaying, she likes both settings. So sometimes if like one isn't working for her and I'm trying to like cook dinner or something, I'll flip her, and then that'll kind of, so that'll actually just get her to be fine if I just like kind of move her, and then she'll get distracted and it'll be fine. So I do really like that swing. Another thing I wanted to mention is this nursing cover slash car seat cover. A car seat cover I feel like is super important. This is something that you probably should have like in your hospital bag. I would recommend, because in the hospital, I feel like especially like when you're going home, everyone wants to like look in your little thing and be like, oh, your baby. And it's like, get away from my child. So this is something I brought with us this time, and you can actually just put it directly over top of your car seat. It just hangs right over top of it, and it has a little hole here where you can put your thing there. And this one is really nice too, because you can use it as a nursing cover. You can actually just put it right over your head and nurse with it, which is nice. It's from the brand Milk-Stab. They have a ton of different prints. I got this one because it was kind of gender neutral and I could use it with both the kids, but there's lots of different prints, and it's a jersey material, so it's really cozy, nice and stretchy. You can also use it on a shopping cart, on a stroller. So we always keep this in our diaper bag, and I'm always using it, especially on our car seat, because I don't want people to get in there with like the germs and things, but I do use it for a nursing cover as well, so it's helpful for that. And then I don't have them with me, but a few recommendations I do want to do if you are breastfeeding is the Hakka. I highly recommend the Hakka if you are breastfeeding, and it's something that I feel like has really helped me both times with both kids. You just attach it on the opposite side as you're feeding on, and it just kind of suctions onto there and it collects the letdown. So it just really does help kind of build up a storage supply. Like I feel like I have quite a few bags in the freezer that I wouldn't have if I wasn't using my Hakka. And it also, in the beginning when your milk is trying to like regulate, I feel like that's really helpful to just pop on there and catch what's being let down. I don't use it as much now just because I feel like we're kind of in a good spot where I know I don't need to be using it as much, but it is something super helpful if you're wanting to build up a stash without having to pump. If you are wanting to pump, I do recommend the Medela hand pump. That is one that I have used this time around, and I had it mid-time with my son. I think I got it at about 6 months with him, but super helpful. I love that one so much more than a like actual big heavy duty pump. I feel like it works so much faster, and it's really just like a manual one. You just like literally pump the thing, but it works so much faster. I feel like I'm able to get like a full pump's worth out of just maybe like, I don't know, 6 minutes it takes to do it. And I feel like I can sit on an electronic pump for like 15 minutes and not even get as much as I can with the manual one. So I definitely recommend getting that one if you have not. And then just some like breast milk storage bags. We like the Up and Up brand from Target. Those are really helpful for storing milk as well. think that's all I have for like the feeding. If you guys want me to do like a separate video on like postpartum must-haves, I could definitely do that too. I'm trying to think if there's anything I forgot, but I believe that is everything that I have for my newborn must-haves. These are items, like I said, essentials that make our life a little bit easier. Not all of these obviously are like things you absolutely need, but a lot of them I do feel like are really helpful at just kind of making that process a little bit easier, helping you find your way and just giving you the items that will, you know, make you have a better, smoother transition into having a baby. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Like I said, I will have links to everything down below. Make sure to check those out if you are interested, and I'll see you guys next time with a brand new video.